Guys, this is Ghostie once again, part of the Engaged Gamers. Welcome back to episode 2 of Haunting Ground. If you're wondering, that's just me cracking open a nice cold soda to help me get through this. So, last time, we made that thing move out of our way, because we're so boss like that. And we're just gonna kick the door open, because I'm still getting used to these controls, by the way. If you're wondering, this is a staircase to nowhere. I actually don't remember if she can actually examine this. Oh wow. Why did the stair stop halfway? The many mysteries of Haunting Ground! And believe it or not, I'm having a lot of fun trying to figure out all the things that she can examine and not examine. Obviously the ladder is not something that we're gonna examine, but hey. And, we also upped the volume, so now I can actually hear things. Oh yeah, that door's locked. But hey, the door is locked! I will need to find a key if I'm going to get through this door. Obvious, Fiona is obvious. This door is unlocked. Also, because we're able to actually kick things now. What's this? Here is one of the many equipable items you will find. That's just one of them. Alright, since I'm pretty sure there's actually no other thingies. Vases, or vases if you prefer, to break. This is a hiding place. Crouch evasion. See? I told you. In addition to evasion points, you can avoid enemies by pressing the L1 button near a shadow. Also, if an enemy is nearby while you are crouching, the camera will change to a first-person perspective so you can watch the enemy as they search around. Utilize this ability if the enemy is chasing you and you happen upon a nearby shadow. Crouch evasion has been saved to your file. So basically, what they're telling you is to do this if you're being chased. Oh wow, I never knew that the piano could actually be heard through this door. By the way, guys, we're coming up to another cutscene, so be prepared as we enter the library now. I don't know why I was trying to push this. If I just apply enough force, I might be able to knock it over. That's something to save for next time. Huh? What's this? By next time, I mean, the next time we get chased. Alright, now I get to be quiet for this cutscene.
Ah, Fiona. I see you finally awakened. There's something that I've wanted to show you for quite some time. Pull away that sheet behind you.
Not really.
That, my dear, is what you will become in the future. Go ahead. You may touch it.
You mean I'm gonna become wood?
Will be mine, Fiona.
Ew, everybody say it with me. Ew, let's examine it. Ew. Okay, I'll stop. What is this thing? Is really giving me the creeps. Why would anyone in their right mind put something like this here? I don't know, Fiona. I think I'll refrain from touching it. Heck, even looking at it makes my skin crawl. I don't blame her. Do you guys blame her? I don't blame her. Not in the slightest. I'd be scared too if some weirdo guy just came up to me and was like,
"You're gonna be mine and I'm gonna make you pregnant."
Yeah, that's how you win ladies over, ladies and gentlemen, is you kidnap them and you make them yours. So I wonder where the garden is. It's probably the place we were at before, so let's get our butts on over here, or we're back over here, rather. Garden key, use. And if any of you are worried, we're about to come up on a clock soon, so don't worry about it, I will save. And yes, I remember which file slot we saved to. We saved to file slot 4. What is that? What is that? Guess what? We'll get an explanation in a bit. Like, seriously, we're like about to get an explanation like right now, I think. Yep. Luminescence. Luminescence, aka Lumies, are tiny creatures that feverishly pursue Fiona once they have caught wind of her. I'm pretty sure that's supposed to be either they. Either they or it. I don't know why they put that. Anyway, when a luminescent makes contact with Fiona, it not only puts her in a state of panic, but it also ruptures, producing a sound which attracts the unwanted attention of nearby enemies. Luminescents, however, do have one fatal flaw in that they do fade over time, but the most effective way to rid yourself of these troublesome creatures is to reach a neighboring area and close the door. That is really important, you guys. Doing this cuts off the luminescent's sensing ability and stops them dead in their tracks. Actually, if they're stupid enough also, they will run into the door and kill themselves. No joke. I've seen it happen. So let's hurry, get in here, and close the door. Bye-bye, luminescent. You're about to die. And I know it because, trust me, you have a short attention span. Or lifespan. Why did I say attention span? That's me. The clock etches out in time, blah, blah, blah. Now we're in the castle corridor. And we have saved. Okay. So, I'm willing to bet you guys are wondering, now what do? Well, we examine this door here. What? There's no knob? Now what do? Wait. There's a hook here. Maybe if I attach something to it, I could use that in place of a doorknob. Oh, we got another comet. Hang on. Oh, crap. We've been having comets this whole time and I haven't heard them. Great. Oh, yeah. We got this comet, like, right after we changed clothing. You guys remember that in the last episode? So, here's what she had to say about that. It feels almost like it was custom tailored to fit me. It really clings to my shape quite nicely, although it feels a little tight in the chest area. And here's what she had to say when we were first being chased. I have to get away, but where to? And this is about the typewriter thing. So this machine is used to engrave letters into these plate things. The only question is, why build a machine for this sole purpose? What do the plates do? Well, we already answered that question, Fiona. So now, here's the question at hand. Judging by the fact that this hook is here, there was probably something hanging here. But what? All very good questions and analyses. So, you're probably wondering what's in certain places. Huh, what's this? Let's pick it up. Cracked plate key. Which one is this, though? Because there's two of them. Oh, we have Camel Belly, too. A metallic plate that has been broken in half. The letters RE are carved into the plate. Guess what? The other half is somewhere around here. So, yeah, this is locked, by the way. Darn, the door is locked. Now how am I going to get this to open? Easy. What could this be used for? There appears to be a slot of sorts. Could this be some kind of lock? Yep. Guess what? Yep. Is this open yet? Yes, it is. Okay. Oh yeah, I forgot. Yeah, of course this is open. So guess what? This is where we're supposed to be. Remember when Fiona was saying we need to get to the map? We're the Hulk here, okay? And trust me, having the map will make me feel a heck of a lot easier. You've obtained Castle Sketch. I know it's not technically a map, but work with me. So, look what we have now. Now we have a map. That little arrow there is where we are. At least I'm pretty sure. There's a big pot here. Break it. What's in it? Chicken jerky! Okay, now that we're done with all that. I forget if this is the part where we get chased again or not. Yep, it is. I should have known better. Close for comfort. And another cutscene. I forgot this is a chain of cutscenes, actually. Oh no! Our leg! Oh no! The doorknob! Oh no! Your face! The chair talked. Oh, he looks so sad. Oh, it breaks my heart. Ow. Ow. Why does he look so sad?
I am Ricardo, keeper of the castle. So sorry to hear about your accident. Your parents. As Master Ugo and Mistress Ayla are both deceased, you, Miss Fiona, are the sole surviving heir of Belli Castle. Are you in pain, miss? Will you be all right? You've had a long day. Please, rest upstairs. Your bed has been
Okay, now if I remember right, I think we have one more cutscene to go through before we get back to gameplay. I really, really hope we don't run past 20 minutes, but we might just. Please let this be a 5-minute cutscene.
It's just a dream. This can't be
Okay, so I forgot that that cutscene actually isn't that long. New comments. My parents are dead? It has to be a lie. Maybe it's all just a dream. Or maybe I am just in shock or something. That has to be it. It just has to be. So, we've got 4 minutes to spare. Guess what we're doing? Well, actually, first, guess what else we're doing? Aside from listening to the poor baby! Oh my god, no! The poor baby! Okay, let's save real quick. Get out of there! Get going! Go get the baby! We're gonna go save the baby! If we're lucky, we'll have extra time and we can get through his cutscene. Cause yes, baby gets cutscene. I'm so sorry, puppy, I'm coming! I'm coming, baby, oh my goodness. Unforgivable! A wire is bound to the poor animal. Is digging deeply into the dog's neck. We're petting his butt, by the way.
Go now, and don't get caught this time.
I can't believe there are people out there that would do this to a poor, helpless animal. And that man, so big and freaky. I just want to get out of this nightmare as soon as I can. And another comment. Poor Pooch. You really look hurt. I hope you'll be alright. Hopefully you'll have enough strength to run away if someone comes after us. See, I really don't know why they put that last little bit there, but it's there. It'll all make sense in this next cutscene. Oh wait, not in this cutscene! I mean the one after this. I forgot that door opens after you free him. Gosh dang it. It's really not that important of a cutscene, trust me. I think you might get a comment out of this too. Nope. No? Okay. Well, let's resume! Okay, we might actually have to mess around. Oh, you know what we can do to waste time? There's like a couple of vases over, or vases in various areas. Let's go kick them. That's empty. That's empty. You must have something. Medallion! Those will come into play later. And they're gonna be really useful, but for now, don't worry about them. I'll explain to them when it comes up. Okay, but, remember when I was saying we couldn't do anything before? You've obtained magnesia, which is another equipable item. Actually, it's the same equipable item that we've gotten before, but hey. This is also a pretty nice Easter egg. I just want to put the terrible things I saw back there behind me. I am not going back. Good on you, Fiona! If you're wondering why I'm wasting time, it's because I'm actually like literally 10 seconds away from cutoff here. So let's hurry back up here so I can pause. Alright, you guys. This is where we say our goodbyes for this episode. Tune in next episode to see our, guess what, next cutscene. This has been Ghosts Are Cool with the Engaged Gamers, and this has been episode 2 of Haunting Ground. Aren't you guys excited? Alright, you guys, see you next episode. Bye-bye!